Okay, meanwhile, there's more fallout over the Jerusalem situation. So Donald Trump, I have to give him credit for this tweet. This tweet, he gets credit for it. He says he's going to move the embassy to Jerusalem, acknowledges Jerusalem is the capital of Israel, as I've said, a move of moral bravery and courage. And he released this tweet, which is, I have to say, pretty funny. This is Trump taunting the, this is 13.
Jerusalem is still the capital of Israel and must remain an undivided city accessible to all.
As soon as I take office, I will begin the process of moving the United States ambassador to the city of Israel as chosen as its capital.
I continue to say that Jerusalem will be the capital of Israel, and I have said that before, and I will say it again.
And Jerusalem will remain the capital of Israel, and it must remain undivided.
We will move the American embassy to the eternal capital of the Jewish people, Jerusalem.
Therefore, I have determined that it is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel.
And he tweeted out above this, I fulfilled my campaign promise, others didn't. Full credit to Trump. This is exactly true. Now, there's a lot of violence that has been breaking out around the world. There are clashes in Judea Samaria and the Gaza Strip. Hamas, of course, is calling for an uprising because they're a terrorist group. That's what they do. One Palestinian protester has been shot dead. But to be frank with you, the levels of terrorism that I've seen so far, the levels of violence that I've seen so far have been relatively innocuous. So they say that there are rallies in Malaysia, Indonesia, Iran, Syria, and even America. Ooh. You mean people in Syria are angry? Oh, noes. You mean people in Iran are upset? Well, I guess that changes everything because Iran was our best friend before. You mean Muslims in Malaysia are very upset about things? Well, unless people are actually like getting hurt or killed, I don't really see. So what? They're protests. Big freaking deal. They protest over, if you said tomorrow, we're going to have a day of rage. Well, we'll call it the Nakba, right? The day that Israel was established, the Palestinians called the Nakba, the disaster. We'll have a day of rage on that day. You'd have the same people protesting. It has nothing to do with Jerusalem. It has to do with the fact they hate Israel. It's that simple. So Thursday, apparently, there were 16 Palestinians wounded. They said that most of the injuries were from tear gas and rubber bullets. And of course, you have all of the usual leftist suspects saying this is going to be the end of the world. It won't be the end of the world. Trump was right to do it. I do want to point out how the media have exacerbated the situation. So Richard Engel, the media like to embed in the Middle East in places like Gaza, and then they just stand around with cameras and watch people burn their own towns. And then they treat it as though something heroic is taking place. This is in Ramallah. Ramallah is completely run by the Palestinian Authority. The Israelis do not run Ramallah. And Richard Engel over on NBC, here's him reporting.
Good morning. As you can probably see, clashes and civil unrest have broken out here in the West Bank. We are on the outskirts of the Palestinian city of Ramallah. These protesters have begun setting fires. They're burning tires to create a smoke screen, and they are throwing stones and other debris. It's difficult to see, but behind this smoke are Israeli troops, and they have been firing volleys of tear gas occasionally to drive the demonstrators back. All these protesters say they are here for one reason, because Palestinians, they say, will not give up on their right to Jerusalem, no matter what President Trump says.
Okay, well, look at the excitement from Richard Engel. You can see the media are really turned on about all of this. What would happen? Let me just pose something. What would happen if the media minimized the coverage? In the same way that the media minimized the coverage of serial killers, but this seems to me very much like the coverage of the riots in Ferguson or the riots in Baltimore. The media love this stuff and they egg it on, and then they're surprised when violence breaks out. That doesn't wash. It doesn't wash at all.